So we'll continue with current affairs on December 2018. This is the second part of our lecture. So we start with the topic governance Aadhaar. The first headline which I have in front of me is you may soon be able to opt out of Aadhaar. So government has now given an option to people to opt out of Aadhaar. So it is section 57 of the Aadhaar Act, which has been struck down by the Supreme Court's constitutional bench. You should know there was the Supreme Court order on Aadhaar. Aadhaar case was before the Supreme Court. Why was Aadhaar case before the Supreme Court? So first we go to the background, then we come to what's happening right now. So the Aadhaar case was before the Supreme Court. It was challenged in the Supreme Court. Why? Is the Aadhaar Act challenged? Why? I'm sorry? Breaching of right to privacy was one concern, and passage as a money bill was also another important point. It was passed as a money bill. Now, what is a money bill? You should know. A money bill is a bill which is for financial purposes only. It is clearly defined in the constitution of the country. As you know, India's constitution is one of the, or rather the lengthiest constitution in the world. So it has all the details in it. So what is a money bill, how it is passed, and what comprises a money bill, the entire list of criteria are mentioned in the constitution itself. So it should be only solely for the purposes of financial matters. So Aadhaar Act, as you can clearly see, it is not just solely for the financial matters. There are other provisions under it too. But it was passed as a money bill. Why? It said allocation, because it is for direct benefit, direct cash transfer, it will be used for social schemes. So financial aspect is involved, so we are passing it as a money bill. But why did the government do so? If it's not a money bill, if it doesn't fall exactly in the criteria of money bill, they should not. Why? It could be passed as a simple ordinary bill. There are ordinary bills too. Why was it passed as, or rather there are also financial bill 1, financial bill 2, which go at the lower end as such. Money bill is solely for financial purposes. Financial bills may include other aspects. But it was passed as a money bill only. Why? Why did government do that? They don't have majority in the Rajya Sabha. The party which has majority in Lok Sabha forms the government, irrespective of what is the situation in Rajya Sabha. So, they did not have. He has the point, but what is exactly. In ordinary bill, what happens in case of an ordinary bill? It has to be passed by Lok Sabha, then it goes to Rajya Sabha, it has to be passed by Rajya Sabha, then it gets the assent of president, passed. If it goes to Rajya Sabha and Rajya Sabha rejects it in case of an ordinary bill, it goes back to the Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha may suggest, okay, we are not happy with this provision. They suggest changes. The Lok Sabha looks at those. If Lok Sabha accepts what Rajya Sabha is saying, then it is considered passed by Lok Sabha, passed by Rajya Sabha, and then it goes and becomes an act. So Rajya Sabha has powers in case of ordinary bill. It can reject, it can say we will not pass this bill. In case of a deadlock, then a joint sitting is also possible of the two houses, and then joint voting takes place. That is in case of ordinary bill. But in case of a money bill, Rajya Sabha has no powers. The bill is passed by Lok Sabha, it goes to Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha has to discuss, debate it, pass it, don't pass it within 14 days, whatever it may do. After 14 days, it is considered passed by both houses, assent of president, and done. So government can do whatever it wants if it's a money bill. So that is why Aadhaar Act was passed as a money bill. So this aspect was also challenged. And also another one was it is affecting right to privacy. So there is a balance which needs to be maintained. Aadhaar enrollment, biometric information, biometric identification of all the citizens of the country being proposed to be gathered. So it should remain secure. There should not be any breach of privacy. So both were to be looked into. So both balancing both is important. So people went ahead and challenged it in the Supreme Court that this violates right to privacy. The government went ahead with even getting mobile phones linked with Aadhaar. There was a deadline, last Feb deadline, if you remember, that link mobile phones with Aadhaar. Then there was linking of for schemes, of course, social schemes. It was there, Aadhaar linking. Apart from that, what else? LPG connections is under social scheme. Telephone connections and PAN cards. PAN cards linking with Aadhaar, bank accounts linking with Aadhaar. So all this was being proposed to be implemented by the government, and challenges went in the Supreme Court. What did the Supreme Court do? What has it done? The Supreme Court gave its verdict. Even before giving the verdict on the Aadhaar case, the Supreme Court referred a matter to a larger bench. It was 5-judge constitutional bench which sat on Aadhaar, hearing the case of Aadhaar, and gave its judgment on Aadhaar. That is fine. But before giving the judgment on Aadhaar, except there is one particular point which has to be referred to a larger bench, and that has to be looked into. So my question is again, what was that point and why a larger bench? What was the point? While hearing the case on Aadhaar, there was this reference made. That wait, we'll discuss and we'll give our judgment on Aadhaar later. First, let's settle this matter. What was that matter? Question of whether right to privacy is a constitutional right or not. So this question has to be settled. Is right to privacy specifically mentioned in the constitution? There are a list of fundamental rights in the constitution. Does right to privacy come under that? Have you ever read it in the constitution mentioned? No. I'm sorry? But what does Article 21 talk of? Right to life. It's basically about right to life. Life and liberty. So it's not specifically mentioned. You will not come across the word right to privacy in the constitution. You will not read it. So there are many rights which the Supreme Court has inferred under right to privacy, right to life. So Article 21 scope is expanded. At one point, Supreme Court also said that if there are no other rights and only Article 21 is there, then all other rights can be included under right to life. Like right to equality, if you have right to life means you have a life with dignity. You need to have equality, you need to have freedom of religion, you need to have freedom of speech. So everything can be inferred under right to equality. Right to life, Article 21. So that's what the Supreme Court has said in a judgment to earlier. So now what question was referred to a larger bench? Whether right to privacy is a fundamental right or not under right to life. So this was put before a larger bench. It was put before a 9-judge constitutional bench. Why such a large bench? Aadhaar case is before a 5-judge bench. Right to privacy case went to a 9-judge bench. Why? Because an 8-judge constitutional bench had earlier already ruled that right to privacy is not a fundamental right. It's a right, but it's not a fundamental right under the constitution. So that was a ruling already there. But now in the new scenario, the Supreme Court wanted to look at the matter afresh. So if it wants to give a ruling, it cannot give a ruling by a 6-judge, 7-judge or even an 8-judge bench. A previous ruling of a Supreme Court can be changed only by a larger bench. So that is why a 9-judge bench sat on that case and it gave the ruling, and the ruling was yes, right to privacy is a fundamental right inferred from right to life under Article 21 of the Constitution. So that ruling came, then came the ruling on Aadhaar. Then Supreme Court gave the ruling on Aadhaar. So now right to privacy is a fundamental right. Now the question before the Supreme Court is whether Aadhaar is violating right to privacy or not. So on that Supreme Court gave the ruling. And what did Supreme Court say? Is Aadhaar violating right to privacy? No. Supreme Court said no. Aadhaar is not violating right to privacy, but it put restrictions. It upheld the Aadhaar Act. It did not look into the money bill aspect. It said it has already been passed. It's fine. They did not give an adverse ruling on that also. So that was also considered yes, done. So that was the ruling of the Supreme Court. So here you can see. This is Supreme Court's Aadhaar verdict. You can see it upheld constitutional validity of Aadhaar with riders, with conditions. Aadhaar can't be mandatory for bank accounts, SIM cards, school admissions. Corporates can't seek Aadhaar for authentication. This was a point on which further clarification was also required. It said corporates can't seek Aadhaar for authentication. Means what? Private sector. Public sector, government uses Aadhaar verification. But whether corporate sector, private sector can use Aadhaar for verification, Supreme Court ruled it can't use. So again the question came, like private sector banks and all, they said if the customers are willingly providing Aadhaar to us, can we use it or not? Because Supreme Court ruling is like that. So government gave clarification that it can be used. So that was done. Then this is upheld passing of Aadhaar as a money bill. Then the viewpoints of the judges on the bench you can see. So Justice Ashok Bhushan concurred with Justice Sikri led majority opinion. The dissent note was given by Justice D.Y. Chandrachud. He highlighted several flaws in the Aadhaar and he clearly stated that money bill route was unconstitutional. This was the dissent note also on the 5-judge bench. So 5-judge bench means if majority of the 5 judges upheld it, it is passed. So there was a dissenting view given. So this again you can see section struck down clearly stated. It is section 33(2) of Aadhaar Act, which talks of identity and authentication data has to be disclosed if it is in the interest of national security. So this and Section 47, which says court shall not take cognizance of offence under the Act except on a complaint filed by UIDA. So restriction on court under Section 47 of Aadhaar Act means if there's an offence conduct under the Act, so the complaint should be filed by UIDA, Unique Identification Authority of India, which is the apex body for implementation of Aadhaar. So UIDA should file a complaint, then court will take cognizance. Otherwise, court will not take cognizance of any offence under the Act. So this has also been struck down. In Section 57 of the Aadhaar Act, that Aadhaar can be used to identify individuals for any purpose by state or companies. So state means government and companies means private sector, public sector, private sector. So this was the section here. These aspects have been struck down. Then Section 33(1). You can see identity authentication records of individuals have to be disclosed on the basis of court order by district judge or above. So this aspect also has been read down, in the sense that you can see individual should be given chance of hearing is what the Supreme Court said. So it's not completely struck down. Those are completely struck down. This is read down in the sense change being sought here. So it should be disclosed on the basis of court order. Means my Aadhaar information is being disclosed. Court said yes, disclose it. But then I should be given a hearing. Individual should be given chance of a hearing. So that is the addition which the Supreme Court order has made to Section 33(1). And then sections upheld are Section 7 of Aadhaar Act, that Aadhaar is mandatory to access social services, subsidies and other benefits. So for all benefits, Aadhaar will be mandatory. And Section 139AA, in which PAN card is linked to Aadhaar, that is of Income Tax Act, that is section of Income Tax Act. Other sections were of Aadhaar Act. See, in UPSC prelims, you will not be asked to mention sections. They may not ask you. Even in mains, nobody is going to specifically ask you. They may ask you a particular question. Sometimes it can be so that a particular question in mains is asked on, say, Section 57. So Supreme Court struck down. What is your opinion on that? And then you would be like, what is Section 57? I don't know. So some important section, maybe a question is asked. But otherwise, if you are having a question on Aadhaar and if you are aware of important, say, 2-3 important sections, and when you are writing your answer and you specifically write mentioning the section, it shows how much in-depth knowledge of the topic you have. So it enhances your answer. So that way it is important. Otherwise, there's not no factual, you need to remember everything. But whatever you can, and if you can write in your answers, it's good. And this is the dissenting view which we saw, Justice D.Y. Chandrachud's dissenting view. So, the Aadhaar project has failed to account for and remedy the flaws in its framework and design, which has led to serious instances of exclusion of eligible beneficiaries, as demonstrated by the official figures from government records, including Economic Survey of India and research studies. Also, you should know that Aadhaar is not citizenship. Yes. The flaws in the Aadhaar Act are first of all about the entire scheme, and it is that if you don't have Aadhaar, as it says mandatory, means if you don't have Aadhaar, you cannot access services. So there are many people who would not be able to have access to Aadhaar.
Of course,
Aadhaar being made mandatory for social services, what does that mean? Social schemes are available to all beneficiaries. Like if you have a BPL card holder, you get the scheme. Like PDS, if you are a BPL holder, you get access to that scheme. Now it is Aadhaar. And if a person is not able to get Aadhaar, you're not getting it. If the biometric identification, that has been a major problem. The biometric reading card, instruments, if they don't work, electricity nahi hai, ya instrument chal nahi raha hai, ya nahi le raha hai, accept nahi kar raha hai. Then the beneficiary is left clueless. They can't do anything about it. So there are these flaws which have come up in implementation of Aadhaar, of course.
Are the identification of companies or individuals by Section 57
identify mandatory nahi hai, in the sense that for my identity proof, when I open a bank account, I have to give an identity proof. If I'm going to a private sector bank and opening my account, Aadhaar being demanded by them is not allowed now. They cannot demand Aadhaar though identity ke liye. That is what is struck down.
But as an identity proof can be used.
So that's what the government has given clarification, because people individually want to use it. So they want, government wants that should not, because this resulted in ambiguity. The Supreme Court, you can't demand is one thing. That is still upheld, but if individuals are giving out of choice, it should be accepted. That way.
Another form of
Identity proof can be Aadhaar. That's what he said. See, there is an Aadhaar Amendment Act bill also under consideration, which is specifically mentioning what the government has clarified. So through a bill also, they will bring in the what they want. And that was not what the government intended to, Supreme Court intended to. Supreme Court ruling did not mean that. But as it is, sentence is mentioned, so it creates questions. So this is again same thing, you can see where it is allowed, where it is necessary. Subsidies, benefits, mandatory. PAN card,
mandatory.
School admissions, no. Other admissions, you can see, no. NEET, etc. Private companies cannot insist on Aadhaar. Mobile phones, no. Bank accounts, no. Not mandatory. Okay. Then this is regarding, again, this is regarding the regulation. So it says, while taking into consideration the concerns of the petitioner, Supreme Court has altered the legal framework. So these are some suggestions which are given by the 5-judge constitutional bench. What we saw was the ruling, yes. When was this? Recently?
Yeah, recently.
So that's what now this is according. Nay, I understand, but then what a Supreme Court has ruled is that it cannot be made mandatory. But the Supreme Court ruling, post the Supreme Court ruling, it is not allowed. I'm sorry? Nay, but maybe this Supreme Court ruling has come recently. So when are you talking about? Maybe it has been time and they have to adhere to the Supreme Court ruling. So when you say no, what do they say? When you say no, what do they say? When you say no to them, what is the response from them?
I didn't say anything. I will take my hand and give
this. So that's how it works. That's how it works in the country. You. There are other identity proofs which can be used. If somebody insists, no, I don't have Aadhaar. So they'll accept it's not mandatory. According to Supreme Court ruling, it is not mandatory. If you have an Aadhaar, you are ready to give it, then they'll take it. They will insist. They will try to get it from you.
If I'm not ready to give, then what should I
Then you
do?
Should find out. You should find out and let us know. See, like a bank, it would not want to lose out. All this was being made, telecom companies were insisting on Aadhaar, banks were insisting on Aadhaar because government was directing them to do so. It was not on their own will. Bank would not say, nahi, humare paas account open mat karo, Aadhaar nahi hai to jao. No, they don't want, they want business, they want customers. But when government says, no, Aadhaar is mandatory, then they will insist on it. Na? If the Supreme Court ruling has come now, Aadhaar is not mandatory, they will not ask a customer to go, no, you don't have Aadhaar, will not open your account. So that is the change which has happened. Then, so then what is there? So this is regarding section 7. You should know this is an important section for benefits. So Aadhaar authentication is required.